focus on some football. Bears and Vikings underway on Monday night.
First play of the drive, loss four. Now they'll look to move it forward here on second and 14. Out of the gun, Fields. This pass caught by Hamler. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. A gain of 37.
All right, Charles, let me put you in the head of one of those defenders out there. You have a big play like that go against you so early. What, does that shake your confidence?
It shouldn't, but it often does, because your thought process all during the week is how you're going to get after that offense and make your plays. And when they make one against you, makes you a little bit hesitant.
Time to regroup.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Moore, the man in motion. Fields on first down. And this one almost intercepted. Not a good play there. Nearly an opening drive, INT. These two teams, you may remember, they met up at Soldier Field earlier this season with the Bears winning that one. So if they can win here in Minnesota, they get a sweep of the season series. Second and 10, Fields again. Oh, tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. And the Vikings are going to go with football here at their own
4-yard line. It's no secret, he's had trouble this year with interceptions, and this is a bad start for him. First drive, throw another pick.
No matter who's broadcasting his game, that's how the conversation begins. Throwing too many interceptions, can he take care of the football?
Cousins and the Vikings with a first and 10 at the 40. They'll begin on the ground with Akers. And he's out of bounds just before the midfield stripe at the 49. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
But you often say that sort of opens the playbook now, second and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while, because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
Just shy of midfield, here's second down and 2. They just do get the playoff. Now Cousins. He's got this to Jefferson. And gets him down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. A game more of 40 big ones.
Already over 1,000 yards receiving this season. That catch is just going to add to his total. Certainly not resting on his laurels. He's trying to continue to gain as many yards as possible and continue this big season.
First down. Here's Cousins. Jones now from his end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And through an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number two?
Going back to your game plan coming in, everyone has matchups that they think they have an advantage. Dial up some of those plays. Try and go to those spots and get your offense moving.
First play of the drive, a success, 19 yards. And first and 10, it's Dobbins. Excellent job pushing through tacklers that time to pick up six. This running game so important for them, and they know that. It helped lead them to a victory last week when he was over 100 yards.
Let's face it, it's their identity, and that's what they want to play to. They want to be that team that runs the ball really well each and every week, and right now we're seeing a pretty good pattern of that happening.
They'll come up on a second and four now from the 40-yard line. Fields going to get that out of line to Mooney. Powering his way forward. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. A gain of 28 yards there, and give him a first down.
I like watching the wide receiver screen because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up to block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
He'll swing this out to Dobbins. And he'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. That's over 40 yards of movement with those last two plays.
And I like the idea here. Get the ball in his hands, even if it's in the passing game. Three catches a week ago, and he does a nice job here to pick up yardage.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Fields. Flush to his right. And he'll take it from the 18 to the 15. A gain of three.
Brandon, once that one broke down, there were only so many options left for him to take. Fortunately, only first down, so smartly got the yardage he could get and didn't worry about trying to turn into a bigger play and end up taking a bigger loss. Here, they hope they can regroup and get something different going here on second down.
Looking to throw on second down, Fields. They set up the screen for Dobbins. But he's down inside the five at the four before he's out of bounds. It's a good gain of 11. Sets him up first and goal.
And when you're throwing the ball downfield really well, like they have been on this drive, it's really a nice time to work one of the screen plays in. One of my favorite play callers in the game has always told me, he starts every game with 10 to 12 screens because if he starts feeling the pressure from the defense, he uses their aggressiveness.
He's got it. Touchdown Bears. 4 yards on the touchdown grab. And the Bears are an extra point away from drawing level. Santos with the extra point. And we are tied at 7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Nwangu now from his end zone.
All right, partner, get that disapproving look off of your face. He did get it out to the 1 yard line. Yeah, I know. Wasn't the best play in the world. He's hoping his offense can bail him out.
The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. And they entered play on a two-game win streak, and then they've got the open date on their schedule next week. So this is a group that's really looking to hit the brake on the high note.
And this will obviously be a tough game for them. But go ahead and play this out with me, partner. If they win here and make it three in a row, they get to heal up after that. You've got to think that's an ideal setup and a worthy goal to play for in this one.
Now a second and six. They'll send a receiver in motion to the left. Here's Madison getting it again on second. And they'll bring him down right around the 13. 7 yards there and a first down. And the Vikings at 5-6 to start play. And they come in feeling pretty good after back-to-back victories, CD.
And I thought that they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their discipline, their resilience, all on display in that victory.
Hey, Clipper, Clipper!
All right, now
here we go.
They'll run on first down with Akers. And he's blocked down before they get across the 20-yard line. 10 yards, and it's good for a Viking first down.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
First down, they'll stay with Akers on the ground. And they'll get him down after a pickup of eight, second and two.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last four plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, four plays in this drive, all four on the ground. Ball on the 30 now. Here's second and two. They'll go again here with Akers. And they'll get up to the 43-yard line. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down.
Well, they came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football. And I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. Jefferson moving in motion left. Here's Madison running on first down. And they get him just short of the 45 at the 44. These two teams all tied after one. Second quarter now from Minnesota. It's the Vikings in possession of the football as they've got it with a first and 10. And that is incomplete. Now the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
I know at times people think we use it too often, but you've got to be able to throw guys open. And when you read zone, you've got to stick it in there before your receiver gets to the next guy in the zone. Otherwise, you bring him into the block.
And that's precisely what allowed that defense to disrupt the pass. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and eight coming up.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Out of the huddle now for play number 9 on this drive. This is third down and 8.
Gun.
Cousins now. That's into the hands of Akers complete. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Bears' 34-yard line. It's a 10-yard pickup, and he moves the chains.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago, because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
The tight end in motion right. On the handoff, running left is Lakers. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up.
And this is why aggressive defense coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D lineman to make the play.
Second down and eight. In motion right is Addison. Here's a run with Akers on second down. And just good downhill running there as he'll take this to the 15-yard line. It's a gain of 11 as the Vikings pick up the first.
I'll be giving up respect to the big guys up front because they have been getting it done on this drive. The holes have been large, and they've been barreling through and picking up first downs.
From the red zone now, Cousins. This is caught. Touchdown. C.J. Ham, his first touchdown of the year. And the Vikings drive the entire length of the field, 99 yards for the score. And he wasn't blocking or running it there. They tossed it to him.
Do you remember the good old days when the 49ers were riding roughshod in the league? They use their fullback and pass plays all the time. Roger Craig, Tom Brady, and those guys were terrific at running these types of plays.
After right down the middle, and that makes the score 14-7. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Here's Jones to bring it out of the end zone. And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line and no further. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And they come into this one riding that nice long win streak. And remember, next weekend is an open week for them. So if they can get the win here, a lot of momentum into that time off.
It certainly is. And if you're wondering if anybody's saying, boy, this is coming at a bad time, we want to keep playing, the answer can be yes. Because when teams are on a hot streak, they want to keep going. But what the veterans are telling the young guys in the locker room, an open week is always good, guys. Take it, and let's go with it.
Here's second and seven. A shotgun snap, Fields. Escaping the pressure right. And he'll be out of bounds at the 25-yard line. Fields, we know he has the good mobility. He flashes it there as he scrambles for the first down.
Well, that's a nice job right there. He's looking downfield, but with no one open, he takes off and tries to run for it. He gets to the sidelines and gets out of bounds with a first down.
Dobbins running out of the game. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1 yard gain up to the 26.
Well, I don't think it's any secret that any running back wants to be able to see a hole open so that he can gallop through it. But in this case, he had to slow down. There was really no hole there. And he took a big hit in order to get that 1 yard.
We've hit the two-minute mark of the second quarter, 14-7. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Here's Fields. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Zone coverage there, they were playing deep. That makes it obviously a little bit harder to run by guys. At that time, there's not much of a window to get the ball in there, and it winds up incomplete.
Now a second and 10. Fields throwing again. And this will be caught by Mooney. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. Catch number 40 for him on the year. It's a first down.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open. Just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. The Bears moving hastily in their hurry-up offense. A play fake, now Fields to throw. That's a short one here, complete to the tight end. That'll be enough to keep the drive moving forward. Another first down on the pickup of 5 yards.
And the tight end is certainly a position built to move the chains because they can control space underneath. If they've got good hands, then, of course, they're a dynamic target. But one other thing is that right in the sight lines of a quarterback on just about every play, and that makes it easier for the quarterback to pick him out and deliver.
A quick throw, right wide to Mooney. Inside the 20 before he's brought down. The Bears on the move. They've got another first down.
When you call a wide receiver screen, no matter how many blockers you get in front of the guy that catches the ball, there's still an aspect of the guy catching it, turning into a runner, breaking tackles, and creating his own yardage, and he just did on that play.
To the air again, Fields. Over complete to Dobbins. And he's got this inside the 10 to the 9 before he's out of bounds. A good pickup there on first as the screen pass gets him 8.
And good yardage there on first down because sometimes all you need to do on the screen is get one key block. That might set your man free, and that was pretty good pursuit to the football defensively. Well, it could have gone for more.
Here we go.
2 yards left on second down from the 9. Fields tapping it forward, jet sweep. And he will maneuver his way down about the 7. Now the Bears going to call the first of their their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in this first half. Here's third and a few inches. Play action. It's Fields. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
That snap is a hit on his defense after the play he just made. What a possession game, and his head kept it exactly that.
The offense here not budging. They're going to fight forward on fourth and inches. Snap it to Fields. On the move to his left. And he's brought down. Can't do anything but a football. It's a sack. And a turnover on downs. The Bears trying it on fourth down, unable to convert. And this long drive is going to wind up yielding nothing. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And with a 14-7 lead, they might just be happy to take this thing on into the tunnel. They'll indeed try to run it out as they start on the ground. An anxious moment or two there, but they do get him down. The Vikings going to signal for the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. Cousins here going to change the play.
Go ahead, go ahead.
Right back to him on first down. And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. Got it here at the 29 on second and 8. They'll keep it on the ground again here. And he'll push forward here for a good little run as the clock continues to run. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. Once again, they'll keep it on the ground. Broken tackle. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. Two quarters down, two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number three. A one touchdown ball game, 14-7 our scores. We get back at it. EA Sports. And the fair catch signal for and taken. So they'll begin this third quarter from their 25-yard line. Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. And they've got the lead, CD. What do you expect from them in the second half?
Well, I like what they were able to do on the ground in the first half because they had a lot of success running the ball, and I certainly think we'll see more of that. But I'd keep an eye on that defense, and I think their coaches up in the box will do the exact same thing. If they start to see one or two guys start to creep towards the line of scrimmage, that'll be licensed to take some shots downfield.
That's to about the 28. Second down coming up.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
Here's second and 7 now from the 28. Play action now, Cousins. Another throw incomplete. He was hit just as he let that go. And now it's third down.
I think he's as fine with that incompletion as a quarterback can be, in all honesty. He avoided his first sack of the game, and he did have a chance of connecting for yardage, just unable to on that throw.
They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on second down.
Good.
Inside the 25-yard line. Yeah, that's good for a gain of 6, and it'll be second down.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
On second down, a run to Dobbins. Get this down inside the 15, even the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
He had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole that closed there quickly at the end. Right back to Dobbins on first. He's going to get 4 out of this as he's down to the 10-yard line.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secure before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
On second down, here's Fields. Eluding the pressure right. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down.
Well, someone's closing in on the league lead in sacks. He came into the game in the top 5. Now you add 2 more to his total.
Third and 8. Converting them into touchdowns.
Yeah, I'm a little bit surprised myself because I thought in this situation they were thinking end zone or bust. Now they got to rely on their defense, get the ball back again for another opportunity to get 6 points.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And we'll see if they can bounce back from that last drive. In particular, if they can bounce back at the quarterback position, Charles, after throwing their first interception of the ball game.
Yeah, and some guys, you know they're going to want to try to get a big play right away and take control of that. Others, they're going to look at a couple couple shorter passes, good little momentum back that way.
But for the defense, that goal is not changing a bit. They want another pick.
You're exactly right about that. In fact, you've got to watch them a little bit because in coverage, they may cut down their gaps a little bit, maybe their splits a little bit in order to try and get to the ball even faster.
Gun.
Second down, they go with Akers again. And he dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Here is third down and four. St. Brown motioning left.
Hey, we're good, we're good.
To throw, Cousins. He's got it, complete. Down the left sideline. Touchdown. Justin Jefferson. 69 yards. And the Vikings are able to stretch out their lead. So on third and medium, they dial up the pass, and it works to hit the end zone.
And it's really not a surprise to me. That's a throwing down in the NFL because of how tough it is to run the football. But what offenses like to do is still show run formations to make them respect it and throw out of those. In this case, they took a nice shot at the end zone and made it pay off.
No run back here for Jones. A touchback. For their next drive, the Bears offense. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it, forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, that's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put six on the board. That's a consolation prize, like going to the county fair. You don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material. Here's second and seven now from the 28. One play action. Fields. The Vikings after it, and they get that for the sack. And the time of out of in there to record the second sack of his young NFL career.
So one quick easy analysis about why they struggled so far. They keep putting themselves in third and long situations. They just took another sack right there.
And the offensive film session tomorrow may be a little longer than it normally is.
Not a lot of positive grades will be handed out thus far.
Taken here right at about the 40-yard line. Just 34 yards on the punt there, no return. And the Vikings will take over here first and 10. The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways because you know they're both motivated. They put a game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
Third quarter on a Monday night with a second and 10 coming up. Now Cousins going to change it up. Run, He'll try again with the arm here on second down. Looking underneath, he's got Akers. And the run pass midfield, just a yard or two short of the 40. And a catch and run there, good for 16 in the first.
Now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try to put the hammer down and finish this one off.
Off the play fake, Cousins. Succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal.
They'll run here with Akers.
Like I said from the beginning, this boy trash. Straight doodle. You being the Eagles is why you win. Boring. You can finesse all your little trades you want. Finesse all your little trades you need. You trash.
Extra point splits the uprights. And the lead is up to 18 now. The kickoff unit is out on the field and they will send.
Shut the fuck up, trash nigga. Shut up. Don't say shit. It's the same as how I had you last game. By 20 points.
To the 25 as Jones elects for the touchback.
So come back. Come back again. Let's see if I throw picks. Come back again. Do that.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. I kind of feel like they've reached a do or die point in this game, Charles.
Oh, my God, it was a pick.
An impressive comeback. It has to.
Boy, that was a pick. He threw it right to me.
They've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions. And you start to think, if it's going to happen for these guys, it's got to start with this drive. Down three scores, they need to start making some inroads. And that'll help the cause there as they pick up good yardage.
Pressure coming from the Vikings, and they get there and bring it down. Multiple defenders there to drop him for a loss of four.
You can just see it in their body language. They're starting to see victory on the horizon now. And if it comes to fruition, they got to give a game ball to the front seven. Defensive line has taken charge and controlled this game. Facing the challenge of stopping this opposing offense, and they've done so with ease.
He's dropped like six picks this year. He has like 82 catches. He shouldn't even have that.
One's going the other way.
On first down, they'll start out with Akers. And he'll be taken down before he works it past the 50. That good for 19 and a first down. And they will not have time to get another play in here. As time has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Jefferson moving in motion left. Bring a receiver in motion left. Here's a give to Madison running right. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and four. Now I think we can get you used to seeing more of that in this fourth quarter, especially if they're having success on the ground like they did there.
Yeah, I think back when we met with the head coach in preseason, and all he talked about was building a bully. And I think it was this situation he was envisioning. Trying to ice a game, plenty of time left, but being able to give the ball to his big runner and pound away and try and finish off a game.
Here's Madison getting it again on second. And the stop here will come at the 48-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, first down. And I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely, you want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38.
Gun. Gun.
They'll go with Akers here up the middle.
And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Run blitz there defensively, something we might see more of here in the fourth quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it. And the difference between that and a pass blitz, you're just trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get to the QB and make sure he gets on the ground. In a run blitz, you're actually trying to cover up gaps. You're trying to cover up holes so they can't run the football.
43 yards rushing for him now to this point.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
They'll bring a tight end in motion right. In motion left goes a tight end. They'll try and run for this with Akers. But he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up fourth down. Now the Vikings will send out the special teams crew here for a field goal try. On the left hash, this from 48 yards. This one is right down
Broadway. So after four touchdowns in the game for this offense, this time they're forced to take you three.
Well, you did mention four touchdowns, right? So 4 out of 5, not too bad. I think that's a pretty good record for them.
No run back here for Jones, a touchback.
Prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense.
But just looking ahead, it would appear that that bye week is coming at the right time. They'll have 2 weeks to chew on this one. They're probably not one that they want to chew on. A poor performance from start to finish.
And the offense moving quickly to the line. It's second and
inches. Fields going to change things up here.
To throw again on second down.
Fields.
To the sideline and incomplete.
And that's another play that's painted the picture of this game overall. That's been a blowout. It's been continually fueled by big turnovers and stops for one side and an inability to advance the ball from the other.
Fields on third down.
Expected they're going for it to keep the drive alive. Pass taken in by his big tight end. Look at the big man rumble. Touchdown, Chicago. A great play there. 65 yards. And the Bears have got it back to a two-score game here in the fourth. Vikings able to tack on the extra point, and the lead will be cut down to 14.
Bears 17. Cairo Santos to kick off for Chicago.
Now after the touchdown here, Santos to kick this one away. Fair catch going to be taken, and this will be moved out to the 25. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. Now there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs to keep up with your theme there on keep away. First downs, they can't touch the ball.
103 yards on the ground for him now as he has gotten better, really, as the night's gone on. Here's a second and two now from the 33. They stop him behind the line. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now third down coming up. They'll need five on this play to move the sticks. On play action, Cousins. He's got his target. That's complete.
Seemingly how it's been all game long. This defense has been just a step too slow. And here they're burned again. Another big play.
Hey, receiver, receiver. Two.
They'll run on first down with Akers. And forget that 100-yard rushing game, at least for the moment, as he'll lose yardage here and fall back under the century mark for the game.
Well, that was one of the few times they've been able to contain him thus far. He's over 100 yards for the game, but he lost a bit off his total on that carry.
2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. You'd have to think likely another running play coming here, second and 11.
Gun.
He's going to get it again. Just looking to get forward and protect the ball. And now right out of the two-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go.
Part of the thinking when you bring in extra tight ends, you're hoping that each of your guys gets those one-on-one blocks and creates a crease for your runner. But the converse is, though, you've got to win those one-on-one blocks. And when you don't, that's the result you end up with.
And he'll be brought down at the 34, well short of the first down marker. Now the Bears going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. And his kick is absolutely perfect. And that will extend their lead even further. So with that, you figure that this game's pretty much out of reach at this point.
Yeah, it's going to take a heck of a comeback to come from three scores down. But don't change that channel. Don't go away. Miracles can happen, and you want to be here in case it does.
You're a company man.
Aren't I, though?
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. Well, this game, it has had no shortage of offense. They've been able to put up a decent amount of points on this side, Charles. They just have not been able to keep pace with the other offense they're going against here.
Yeah, it's a good way of pointing things out because now it's not a total loss because, as you said, they've scored some points, so there's some plays they can build on, moments where the game plan actually worked. But overall, though, they were just out personnel. They were going up against a team that's playing at an elite level.
Now
Dobbins again on second down.
And some room to work. Down the sideline he goes. And he is finally forced out of bounds inside the 30-yard line. 71 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries. He had been held in check. Now he breaks that big run. Shows the explosiveness we all knew was there.
All right, tell the truth now. You knew it was just a matter of time, didn't you? We've seen this so many times from him. Hold him down, and then breaks out.
J.K. Dobbins, his 21st touchdown of the season. And the Bears are able to cut into that deficit. Santos with the extra point, and the lead is trimmed down to 10. So two scores down, time definitely not an ally, but here comes the onside kick. And the Vikings hands team able to recover. And that should just about do it. They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none. We've got to have two hands on the football here as they run on first down. And he's got it across midfield and into Bear territory. Nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down. Charles, why didn't they just take the knee there?
You're asking the question that I'm asking as well, because we've seen a lot of football where coaches decide maybe they get a little greedy. I don't know if they're doing it for stats or for what reason. We've seen it happen in college. How about the NFL? The miracle of the Meadowlands. All they had to do was take a knee, and the game was over. The Giants ran it one more time, ball popped free. Philadelphia picks it up and wins the game.
What year was that?
1978. I think it was in November.
The fuck off my field. Tell him to get off the field, chat. Oh, you're probably looking for my stream and it's private.
You really don't like very much, too.
So for the Vikings, the win gets them back to 500 at 6-6 on the year. And they'll be able to enjoy this one through the bye week before they get back at it again. Meanwhile, for the Bears, it's a tough one to swallow as they drop back.
Get off my field, chat. Fucking bitch. No, that's the nigga that's in the league that's an admin with me. Be talking all his little woofing and shit. Like, I was beating this nigga ass, like, 20-0, 26. And I fucking started passing the ball in the second half, and he beat me by, like, 4-8 points or some shit. He came back. So I threw, like, 7 interceptions. And he was like, nigga, you choked. And I was like, okay, well, at least I know you didn't beat me. It was all me. Yeah, it was me throwing the ball, throwing interceptions. I choked. Okay, well, it wasn't like you were good enough to play against me and beat me. Like, you didn't beat me. So I play him again through one pick, which was, whatever. Beat his fucking ass. It's fucking 34-17, like 34-10. So 34-10. So I'm like, I'm talking shit in the mic. Like, yeah, and I told your ass, so you was trash, and it was me. You know what I'm saying? Like, and he going to say something. I don't know what he said because I can't hear him. My shit muted. Like, I can't hear them talking. But so he hear me, but I can't hear them. That's the beauty about my headphones. Like, I can turn them niggas out, and I can just talk shit all day long, right? And so this bum ass nigga, like, he's saying something. Fuck what he talking about. I'm gonna get fucked about what you talking about. Like, bitch, you suck. Like, nigga, you suck. Fucking ass. He made a rape trade to one team to get a cornerback that I just torched the fuck out that nigga. Like, get the fuck out of here, you fucking bum. You're a bum. For real.